Here's a Bako, my first Bako. This one is one that used to be a 6mm, but I needed something a little bit smaller in between an 1/8 and 6mm. So over the years, I've kind of ground these sides down a little bit at a time. It's about where I need it. Check if I've got clearance. Nope, got to come out a little bit more. Perfect. It doesn't have really easy adjustment because when this thing locks down, and that's good and bad, so it makes it a little more difficult to make micro adjustments. You have to kind of break the whole bond and then start again. That's why I put the little marks to know where I make my micro adjustments. But the good thing is that once this thing is tightened down, you're never going to be in the middle of a sharpening operation and it will have moved around on you. That's not going to happen. And that's really important. So you're not gonna be, you know, sharpening along and then realize that, oh, you know, my angle has changed and now I've blunted off all the hard work that I've done to get it up to this point. Looking good. The chances of you being this low with the jig are probably pretty slim because your chisels are probably a lot longer than mine. So the angle, it will be a lot different. But my chisels now, these Bakos are getting so short after 25 years of grinding on them that this angle is really, really laying down. But it still works. Perfect clean facet front to back all the way across it in just a, you know, matter of minutes. I don't have my burr yet, so let me take a couple more swipes at it. There's my burr. Fine. Coarse. That was extra coarse before. Thank you. nice burr on the back. Oh, this baby's gonna cut like gangbusters. This one's really handy for cutting down into, after I've done plunge routing, cutting mortises. You square out that square out the rounded end where the router bit has gone down in there, and it's always real hard to clean out that last little bit where the flat side of the mortise meets the square side that you cut with the chisel. So this guy will get down in there without any resistance and just pierce and puncture that last little bit down there really, really quickly. Okay, so now I'm ready to sidetrack yakking. Get the fine over here. Extra fine. That is one sharp knife right there.